Hi everyone, and welcome back to our channel where we,
yeah,
and John show you how to make the world more accessible with technology. Today we have a video for you in which we're going to show you how you can use the Microsoft Adaptive Hub and buttons as a mouse alternative. This is great for anyone who has difficulties using a regular mouse or the adaptive mouse. All right, let's get started. First, we need to turn on the hub, the D-pad and the dual button. Then we need to open the Microsoft Accessory Center on our PC, and we should see them all listed here. Now we're going to configure the D-pad button first and use it to control the cursor movement. We click on the D-pad button and then on the up button. We choose the move cursor option from the drop-down menu and set it to up for the cursor direction. This means that when we press the up button on our D-pad, the mouse cursor will move up on the screen. We also want to increase the cursor movement to 15 so that the cursor moves faster. And we also want to enable the press and hold option so that we can keep moving the cursor as long as that D-pad up button is pressed. That's it for the first button. Now let's do the same thing for the second button and go clockwise. We click on the up and right button and choose move cursor and set it to up and right for the cursor direction. We also set the cursor movement to 15 and enable the repeat option. We're going to continue clockwise and repeat these steps for all the other buttons until we have assigned all 8 directions of cursor movement using our D-pad button. And that's how we set up our D-pad button as a mouse alternative. Now, let's move on to the dual button. We click on it in the accessory center and then on the left button. We choose mouse action left click from the drop-down menu. This means that when we press the left button on our dual button, it will act as a left mouse click on our system. Then we do the same thing for the right button and choose mouse action right click. And that's how we set up our dual button as a mouse click alternative. Now we're done with the setup, let's see them in action. As you can see, Yara can easily control her PC using only these two buttons. Now think about adding another button for copy, paste, open applications, browse websites, basically do anything else you want to do with your system. We hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new today. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching and see you next time.
In welk vak staat 1 goudvis?